Welcome to Remediating Security Events with Jamf Pro, Connect, and Protect. I'm Katie McKay, Consulting Engineer for Security here at Jamf.
And I'm Sean Rabbit, Consulting Engineer for Identity and Access Management. Since this session is being recorded and will be available after JNUC, we'll have the handouts including scripts and links to the tools we used available on GitHub, as well as any changes or errata found after this recording. Remediating security events with Jamf Pro, Jamf Connect, and Jamf Protect, or also known as two people in front of two curtains. A big long name for a session, but boy howdy, have we got a lot to get through in a short period of time. So let's actually start at the end. Katie, would you like to walk us through what the ultimate result will be?
Absolutely, Sean. So what we're going to show you here is a computer enrolled in Jamf Pro with Jamf Connect installed and handling the logins on a machine and monitored with Jamf Protect. This will be the end result of what you can do with the tools combined. First, Dwight starts his day the way he usually does, logging into his Mac, as you can see here, with the logo of his org and a customized background image. Very pretty. And now in a twist of events, he's going to install a Bitcoin wallet and trading program that he found on a thumb drive out in the parking lot. Silly Dwight. Ignoring all of the warnings that macOS is throwing at him that this is a bad app and will damage his computer, Jamf Protect halts the process and isolates the crash reporter malware. Our IT team has had to deal with Dwight in the past, of course, so having detected that there is yet another new malware installed on this machine, we're going to lock Dwight out of his computer until someone on the IT team can figure out if this was a blocked threat to other devices on our network. Jamf Protect tells Jamf Pro to drop this device into a special smart computer group of pwned machines. Jamf Pro then updates the config profile for Jamf Connect almost instantly, locking Dwight out of the machine, rebooting the computer. Now presented with a brand new warning lock screen to easily identify the computer as possibly compromised, Dwight desperately tries logging in, thinking he could somehow still cover his tracks. He's, of course, denied. Dejectedly, he calls Kelly, and since she is a member of the IT team access group, she's able to have an admin account created on the machine just in time with Jamf Connect. The security team can now perform a forensic analysis of the machine to make sure that nothing bad can affect the rest of the org. Lastly, Kelly opens the self-service for Jamf Pro to run a script to clear the Jamf Protect blocks. Jamf Pro then nearly instantly sends the original config back down to the machine to let Dwight stumble forth in his day pretending to work.
Our automatic Jamf Connect settings. And hey, we're back to normal. Life is good. Go forth and work, Dwight. Life is good. Now, Jamf is the only enterprise management solution. The entire lifecycle of Apple in the enterprise, including device deployment, management, security, without negatively impacting the end user experience or requiring IT to even touch the device. Also known as blah, blah, blah sales pitch and why you're not here. So let's dig into what we actually use to get this done. This solution uses three specific products of the Jamf product portfolio. And if you've been paying attention so far, they are Jamf Pro, used to manage a computer and make it do pretty much anything up to and including telling to sing happy birthday on a Tuesday afternoon if it's scheduled to rain. Jamf Connect to gate access to macOS client machines and create new user accounts just in time. And Jamf Protect, the purpose-built Mac endpoint protection software. So let's actually break down what we saw. Katie, can you walk us through it?
So when Dwight installed that malware on the machine, a combination of the native macOS XProtect and Jamf Protect kicked into gear immediately and blocked the malware from being installed on the machine. Because Jamf Protect can communicate with the Jamf Pro binary on the client machine, It triggered an inventory update called Jamf Recon, which then went out to the Jamf Pro server in the cloud. The Jamf Pro server then saw the inventory had updated and that Jamf Protect marked the machine as being compromised with an extension attribute collected during the inventory. This then told Jamf Pro to put the device into a smart computer group. And since a smart group can be used as a target for things like policies or config profiles, Jamf Pro sent a command to the device to execute a remediation script and a config profile for Jamf Connect. The script in this case ran a message with Jamf Helper, a messaging tool included with the Jamf Pro binary when a device enrolls in management. Another great tool you can use to really block anything on the device is the open source tool from Jamf called DEP Notify. Joel Rennick's great program can put a customized message up on the screen in full screen mode, completely blocking a user from doing really any other interaction and forcing a computer to reboot after a user has read the message. It should also be noted that these messages are completely customizable. The config profile sent down was an updated set of instructions for the Jamf Connect software. Sean, want to walk us through that?
Absolutely. Jamf Connect uses an application defined in a cloud identity provider to determine who gets access to a client macOS device. Now, normally, you'd have that application set up to let everyone in the organization log into a computer. But there's absolutely nothing stopping you from setting up multiple applications in your identity provider. Think of that as having a special access control list for security staff only. So when Jamf Connect goes out to the IDP to say, hey, can this dude log in? The identity provider responds, none shall pass.
Now, while all of that was happening, Jamf Protect was also busy sending the full details of the security incident to the Jamf Protect cloud instance and optionally to a SIM of the organization's choice. Now, when Kelly goes to investigate Dwight's computer, she's got details about the detection type, where the file originated from, who executed the command, and if we detected a unique targeted piece of malware, a signature that can be blocked from any other devices in our org's fleet.
With an automated policy, Kelly then told the computer to run a script to clear the extension attribute and update the inventory in Jamf Pro after she investigated the machine. This then removed the computer from the smart computer group that restricted access. The updated inventory then removes the device from the smart computer group, which tells the Jamf Pro server to send an Apple Push Notification Services, or APNS, command to remove the config profile for restricting access and add the config profile to return the normal access to the computer.
Now let's get into the nuts and bolts of how this workflow is set up. And in addition to the session, you can read all about this process, how to update analytics to include Jamf Pro Smart Groups, and more at the Jamf Protect documentation link above.
Or below, depending on where we're at in this picture. I have no idea anymore. It's all good.
So first, we need to set up a communication path between Jamf Protect and Jamf Pro. So to do that, we'll tell Jamf Protect to add an extension attribute to the device inventory record. This attribute is set on each analytic of interest. In our examples, we used a concept of high, medium, low, and a special category of malware. Why is that? Well, an analytic may be something innocent, a developer running a script to do some automated action, which asks for input for a pseudo command, or it could be a known malware signature or behavior, and we may be a target of a new script kiddie stealing a developer certificate and targeting our organization. Our IT security team can set priorities based on what they think is a risk factor in each analytic. Next, we essentially tell Jamf Pro to collect this information. Built into Jamf Pro under extension attributes is a template that collects this information from Jamf Protect. Now that analytic detection notice is part of the device inventory record. And lastly, to act on that analytic automatically, we'll create a smart computer group. Smart computer groups can be used as the target for a policy or a configuration profile to be applied to a machine or a group of machines. We'll use some more of this later when we make some config profiles appear and disappear.
Now, the trick here is the computers may not always be connected to the internet, and they may not always be able to receive commands from Jamf Pro. To work around that, we'll actually tell our policies that they should be able to run offline in Jamf Pro. In the execution frequency in a policy, we have a simple option, make available offline. Just enable that option on any policies that will be triggered by the smart device group join.
So now that we've got our event detected, we'll want to have a policy run that actually does something on the machine, maybe a script to alert the user that, hey, we're not blaming you, but something just happened on the machine and we're shutting down Right Meow. The policy can do literally anything on the machine since it runs as a super user with admin rights. Now in this case, we're just running a quick script and we'll get into that magic in a second, but the real trick is how to trigger the policy happening. When the Jamf Protect agent finds an analytic, which will cause an extension attribute to be created, it also does the equivalent of running the Jamf policy event command with the custom trigger of Protect. Custom events are amazingly powerful tools which can trigger a cascading series of events to happen within the Jamf Pro agent. The last two pieces of the puzzle are to set the execution frequency to ongoing, as we never know if there's going to be a lightning strike twice in the security space, and to make sure the policy is available to run offline if a computer has become disconnected from the network. And then this particular action is creating a little pop-up window in the Jamf helper script. We'll put a link to this in the handouts, but this script can be quickly modified to suit your needs and could even be passed fields with the script parameters from Jamf Pro to Jamf helper. In this case, we're setting the default path to the Jamf helper app, which comes installed when the Jamf binary is installed on an enrolled machine. We'll put some variables to set the text shown to the user, and then when the user clicks out of the message, we'll run a shutdown with a reboot command.
Now that script looked very complicated, but you can actually simplify a lot of it by using the Jamf Helper Instructor app. And while we're putting the message up just as a box on the screen, note that you can have a whole bunch of different settings. So we can also force it as a full screen application to prevent the user from doing and switching to anything else. And we don't have to limit ourselves to just Jamf Helper. No, our script can get fancy, so fancy. Our script could use other great tools like Joel Renich's DP Notify script to give even more information to the user on what's going on. It could run additional Jamf Pro policies to delete potentially dangerous files or quit processes, reboot machines, and more. What we're showing you is just the idea and the base level. The limit is really only your imagination. Now, the Smart Computer Group is doing more than just triggering the policy for isolating the machine. It's also modifying the configuration profiles issued to a machine. Jamf Connect requires two things. First, you need to have the Jamf Connect program installed. Second, you need a configuration profile to tell Jamf Connect where to authenticate a user. Now, this can be used to our advantage. First, Jamf Protect dropped the dime on this computer and therefore it fell into a smart computer group. Smart computer groups can also be used as an exclusion group to take a configuration off a machine. So in this case, we can use that group to drop the standard Jamf Connect let everyone log in off of a computer. Next, we can use that same group to scope on additional settings for Jamf Connect. So in this case, we've added a special subset of users to our Okta tenant, made it so you absolutely had to authenticate with the network, changed the background wallpaper of the login screen to screaming red. And you're not limited to just Okta in this case. There's really no limit to making additional application registrations in all of the identity providers. In this case, we'll only assign members of the InfoSec team to allow to use this application. And this picture being shown right now is an option in Microsoft Azure. Then we'll apply a config just for the InfoSec team so they can access Jamf Connect and log into the Mac.
Now, after all the action has taken place, you're really going to need visibility into what actually happened. In the Jamf Protect console post-incident, you can see intricate details about the processes that ran, where it came from, its signing info, and much more.
And now that we've got all the information about the security incident, now that we limited the damage to the rest of our fleet by restricting Dwayne's access to his own computer, or Dwight's access. Who's the person in this? Again, I can't even remember. I didn't even watch The Office. Now that Kelly cleaned up the computer and made sure there was no lasting damage, let's let him get back to work. Jamf Pro Self-Service lets administrators create policies that can do many things, like install applications, apply settings, and run scripts. In this case, we've created a self-service policy that'll clear the extension attribute information written by Jamf Protect on the client machine. The clearing script is possibly one of the simplest policies you may ever write. Simply run a Unix command to clear the Jamf Protect Smart Groups directory shown here, and then tell the machine to submit an inventory update. This will clear the extension attribute, clear the Smart Group, fix the Jamf Connect login screen, and return the computer to normal automatically. It's really that simple.
Now what to do next? So when you choose an analytic to apply this workflow to, you'll really want to assess the impact to your organization if by chance that targeted malware was ever successful. Then you'll want to decide what to say to your end users. Do you want to give them a lot of detail or a little? Do you want your company logo on it just so you don't scare them? And speaking of scaring your end users, you may want to educate them on what will now happen if they make an oopsie and download malware. You'll want to make sure you've successfully implemented your workflow, but in a harmless way by launching something like an ICAR file and not actual malware.
And remember, and the stuff again, that we're going to be showing the stuff that we're linking in the GitHub script here is really just the beginning. We'll give you some samples, and then anything that you want to do to those scripts to modify them is entirely up to you. Sorry, back to you, Katie.
And lastly, remember that Jamf support is available for any of the individual products we discussed here, but they're unable to help with custom scripting. So if you need assistance with configuring Jamf Pro, Jamf Connect, or Jamf Protect, please reach out. If you do need help with custom scripting, however, Jamf has a professional services team who can come in like the pros from Dover and do this work for you. Be sure to refer to this specific session to discuss that you want was in the to discuss that you want was what was in this session done in your environment. Sorry.
It's all good. Just a complicated way of saying, hey, I want that for me. It's all good. So
yes,
we'll be able to help out. So a short session here, but you've got the idea that basically a combination of Jamf Pro, managing Jamf Connect on a client device, and then listening to Jamf Protect on the client device will be able to clean up the computers for you automatically, or at least pull out from being able to injure the rest of your entire fleet of machines. For Katie McKay, I'm Sean Rabbit.
And for Sean Rabbit, I'm Katie McKay. Thanks for watching and enjoy the rest of your JNUC 2021.